What's up?
What's up?
What's up? In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can become an exchange student. You'll live abroad, learn a new language, make international connections, and have the adventure of a lifetime. But there are a few things that you need to do first. Now, there are quite a few programs and quite a few ways to become an exchange student, and it's going to depend largely on what country you live in and what your budget is. Now, you can go through Rotary, ASSE, AFS, but for simplicity's sake, I'm going to highlight the process and requirements of an American doing a long-term exchange through the Rotary Youth Exchange Program, because that's what I did, and it is one of, if not the most, economical option. As for requirements, there isn't a whole lot, actually. You just need to be between the ages of 15 and 18 and a half by the time that you arrive in your host country. You have to be open-minded, be willing to live in a foreign country with foreign families for a whole academic year, attend a local high school, and go through an extensive interview process that takes months to finish. Now, there are also shorter, 3-month long exchanges during the summer, but from what I've heard, the process is more or less the same. Now, if you meet all those requirements and you're absolutely psyched about going abroad, then the first step for you would be to contact your local Rotary Club, express interest, and schedule an interview for the beginning of the school year. I've included a link in the description that has a tool that'll help you find the closest Rotary Club to you if you don't know of one. There will also be a ton of other information down there about Rotary and about the process itself in general. And before you go to the local interview, all you have to do is fill out a common application that just asks some general questions about you and about your family. Now, when you actually go to the local interview, you can expect one, maybe two Rotarians, plus maybe a former exchange student that will be there to help interview you. It only lasts around 10 to 15 minutes, and it's more of a pleasant conversation than anything else, so don't stress too much about it. They're all just volunteers looking to give back to their community, and they have absolutely no intention of hurtling double-edged, loaded questions at you. A week or two after this, they'll send you an email inviting you to the Rotary District interviews if they feel that you are suitable for the program. This is also when you get absolutely bombarded with paperwork. You'll need to provide a health examination form signed by both your dentist and your primary physician. You'll also need all of your immunization records, a Rotary guarantee form, proof of travel health insurance, and any other paperwork that may or may not be exclusive to your club. On top of this, you'll obviously have to apply for a passport if you don't already have one. You'll also need to submit a personal essay about why exactly you want to be an exchange student and why you think you'll be a good fit. Then you'll have to persuade a parent or legal guardian to write a little, small personal narrative about you so that Rotary knows that your family supports you in your endeavor to become a global citizen. Now that you've completed the paperwork stage, it's time to get through the district interviews. And boy, are they a doozy! They consist of almost a full day of questions where you go from room to room being interviewed by different members of Rotary, with every single room being different from the last. You'll probably meet several country contacts, the Rotary security officer, your outbound coordinator, and several other members of the Rotary board. But there's one room, and one room in particular, that stands out for its intensity and for its ruthlessness.
The Rotex room.
Rotex is a group within Rotary that is made up of only former successful exchange students, and if you want to go on exchange, then you have to run the gauntlet and get the rite of passage from people that have completed the same exact process before you. When you step inside the Rotex room, you can expect to see anywhere from 10 to 30 former exchange students surrounding this little chair in the center of the room for you to sit in. There are no smiles, there are no greetings. You come in, they tell you to sit down, and the most demanding part of the entire process then ensues. They bombard you with questions, one after the other, that have no apparent correct answer. You can say anything in the world, and they'll find a way to use it against you. One such question I got was, how many times a month do you depend on your parents to help you make a decision? Now, you obviously will not know an exact number, so you'll give them an estimate. If it's high, they'll ask you, why aren't you independent enough to make your own decisions? If it's too low, they'll ask you, why don't you respect your parents enough to ask them what they think? If you took a foreign language in high school, they may even ask you a question in that language, or just for the shits and giggles, they'll ask you to pronounce something in a language in a completely different writing system that you're unfamiliar with. Then finally, when it's just about to be over, they'll put you on the spot and ask you to do something memorable in just a few seconds, which is just yet another opportunity for you to embarrass yourself. Now, they want to see if you can withstand adversity and stay calm under pressure, which is the whole point of this. Now, I've been on both sides of the room. I've seen people hold their own, and I've seen people break down and cry, but I know that one thing is for sure, and that is nobody is comfortable in that room except for the people asking the questions, and that is the whole point of it. But the good news is that it has to end sometime. And if you pass the district interviews, you'll definitely get a chance to meet all of the road techs that interviewed you, and you'll very soon find out that they're an incredible group of intelligent, cultured, multilingual, global citizens with endless stories and compassion, and that is a reward in of itself. After the district interviews, all of the people within Rotary that interviewed you will then convene somewhere and discuss where in the world they think you'll be the most successful. They take your country preferences into account, duke it out, and essentially decide where you're going to be living for the next year. However, this is done in secret, and you'll likely never hear anything about this part of the process at all. Now, assuming that you've passed the 10-foot hurdle that is the district interviews, you'll then receive an email telling you which country you've been assigned to and that you've officially been accepted into the program. Now, even though certainly a congratulations is in order here, you still have a couple more things to do before you leave. You'll have to go through 3, maybe even 4 mandatory orientations within the next 6 months where they'll go over the rules, answer all your questions, and prepare you for your year abroad. Think of it as Army boot camp before you deploy, but just without the grenades. And then you'll be assigned a country contact, which is just a person that is incredibly knowledgeable and most likely speaks the target language of the country that you've been assigned to. Now, being at these orientations will also give you the incredible opportunity of making friends with all the other people that also applied to Rotary within the same year. Once you're in this stage, this is a time of preparation and concentration. Ideally, you'll be studying your host country's language, getting to know a little more about the geography, politics, and culture of your host family, and applying for a student visa so that, you know, you don't get deported once you actually get there. During this time, Rotary will also help you with your airline tickets through a travel agency and getting your visa. Somewhere around this time, you'll finally get a chance to establish contact with your first host family in your assigned country, which you should absolutely do as soon as possible. After you finish all of the orientations, the only remaining Rotary obligation is the Welcome Home Dinner, which is an event that takes place after your exchange. There will likely be hundreds of people at this event, and you'll be required to give a presentation or speech about your year abroad. But just remember that you'll have to do a lot of public speaking while you're in country anyway, usually in your target language. So by the time that you get back, speaking in front of hundreds of people in your native language will seem like nothing, which is one of the many benefits of taking a year abroad. Now, I'm sure you guys are wondering about the price, because this sounds all fine and dandy and all, but if it's too expensive, you obviously can't go, right? The other thing is, the price can vary depending on which Rotary Club you belong to. For me, it was one flat fee of $5,000. Now, that may seem like a lot, but remember that you are paying for a full year here, and it even includes your plane tickets. It's also worth mentioning that there are absolutely payment plans available, as well as some scholarships, maybe depending on which Rotary Club you belong to, as Rotary is a 100% volunteer organization. Having all this in mind, now you can finally go abroad. At some point, you'll receive a departing and arrival date from the travel agency, and you'll finally embark on this amazing once-in-a-lifetime adventure. You'll probably end up leaving anywhere between June and August, depending on the country, and considering that you started this interview process way back in September or August, this is truly an indescribable feeling once you're all done with the legal formalities. All you need to do now is just wait until your time comes, and then you'll finally go out and get to experience what many of us describe as one of the best years of our lives. My exchange completely changed me as a person for the better, and it also never hurts to have an international network of friends that are willing to open their countries and sometimes even their homes to you if you get the opportunity to travel later on. And it's just that simple, guys. There are a lot of minor intricacies within the program, but this is everything that you possibly need to know to become an exchange student through the Rotary Youth Exchange Program. Hopefully, the current global situation will improve soon and will only catalyze our budding interest of wanting to expose ourselves to this big wide world and contribute to worldwide peace one exchange student at a time. Thank you all so much for sticking to the end. Be sure to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.